My name is Nicole Faraday and I play Kim Brooks in the film Kill Kane. So I play Vinnie Jones's wife in the film. We're just an average family. And then one day we witness a gangland killing, which obviously, unfortunately, brings us into this whole criminal underworld, which we're not used to at all. And then it has really devastating consequences. And that's the main crux of the film, basically. A normal family whose lives are torn apart by witnessing something out of the ordinary. And then suddenly they're dragged down into this kind of criminal underworld. I love the fact that even though it is a gangster movie per se, but it's not just a run-of-the-mill gangster movie, it's got a real heart to it. The fact that it is about a normal family and you can kind of slightly put yourself in their shoes, in the fact that you think, God, if this could happen to me, how would I feel? How would I cope with it? It's not just your usual kind of gang, you know, shootout sequences. There are shootout sequences, but it is a film with a heart, and I think that that's quite a good backbone, and it makes it different to the normal kind of gangster flicks that you get these days. And I think what attracted him to the role really was the fact that it is a different kind of role to the kind that he normally plays. Obviously, people normally think of him as Vinnie Jones' hard man. And although he does end up being the hard man, as I say, he doesn't start off that way because he's a PE teacher. I'm his wife. We have two kids. We live in the suburbs. And then, as I say, by one tragic kind of evening that we witness these tragic events, and then it has these consequences. So it's quite nice because he starts off, he's more of a goodie really rather than a baddie, where he's normally the baddie. So you're rooting for him in this film.
And what does it mean for you to bring the film specifically here to BAFTA tonight?
Oh, it's so exciting. I mean, BAFTA, amazing. I'm thrilled to be here among lots of friends of mine, lots of colleagues that I've worked with before, such as my lovely friend Adam Deacon around there, who actually won a BAFTA a few years ago. So I'm very pleased that he's with us tonight. It's just fantastic. It's a great opportunity for me to get to see it. I haven't seen it on the big screen yet. I've seen a sort of rough edit, but this will be really exciting. They've got a whole new edit for the big screen, and seeing all the cast and the crew and everything, because we had really good fun making this, and it was Easter we did it, so it's a really nice get together and reunion, and exciting, and hopefully it will generate lots of interest in the film, because I think it's out on DVD now, so hopefully people are buying it. I've done a couple of films recently that are coming out this year. There's a film called The Lock-In, which was written and directed by Jeremy Edwards, who you may know from Holby City, Hollyoaks, that kind of stuff. And that's the first in a trilogy that he's doing. And my character recurs in all three. So we've got another two of them to film, which is good. And also I did a film recently called The Neighbours with Lynn Lowry, who's quite famous for doing lots of horror films. So it was quite exciting for me to do it's only a short, but it's a horror film where I'm working alongside the scream queen, Lynn Lowry. So yeah, a couple of filming projects and a couple of theatre tours I'm doing as well.